for today's top stories, let's go over to the CBN News Desk.
Gordon, the trial of Fort Hood massacre suspect Nidal Hasan resumes today in Texas. Hasan is acting as his own defense attorney, but now his standby defense team is demanding that it be allowed to take over his case or be excused. Ephraim Graham has the story.
Lawyers say Nidal Hasan has a death wish, and they want no part in it, stating, "We do not think it is wise to help him achieve that goal. It is repugnant to defense counsel." Hasan represents himself, but Colonel Chris Poppy is his lead standby attorney in case he changes his mind or needs advice. Wednesday, Poppy told the judge, in his mind, Hasan actually wants the death sentence.
Their job is to represent their client, to prevent him from getting the death penalty. Their perspective or perception is that that's something that he in fact wants.
In Hasan's opening statement Monday, he admitted the evidence would clearly show he was the shooter. He went on to tell the military jury he was a mujahideen, an Islamic fighter engaged in a religious fight, and he hasn't cross-examined any witnesses.
He's saying that he was trying to prevent Americans from killing the Taliban. Mm-hmm. The judge has rejected that defense for some reason, but his own words are declaring that it is terrorism.
Hasan is charged with the murders of 13 people and the attempted murder of 32 more. He tried to plead guilty before the trial began, but the government denied the plea because it wouldn't have allowed them to pursue the death penalty. Meanwhile, many victims and their families are suing the government, because they say political correctness kept the military from stopping Hasan. Observers say for whatever reason, the military missed the warning signs.
I do compare this to the Boston bombing, that there are facts there that could have prevented it, that the FBI had, that did not share with the Boston police. And I think that a lot of the people that saw his radical behavior were not reporting it to the proper authorities, or those that did receive the information did not want to handle it for whatever reason. And it is disappointing.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Members of Congress and their staffs will still get financial aid from the government to help pay for any new health care plans under Obamacare. The government has paid for a majority of health care premiums for Congress and their staffs in the past, but a statute in the Obamacare law said they had to buy their health care plans through the new insurance exchanges. That would have meant a huge increase in costs. But new guidelines from the Office of Personnel Management will let the members and their staffs keep their financial aid from the U.S. government. The Pentagon could begin giving benefits to gay spouses in the military by the end of the month. A proposal would give same-sex spouses access to military health care and housing programs. An earlier plan to give benefits to gay partners who are not married is being reconsidered. The Pentagon might instead give same-sex couples 10 days of leave to travel to states where they can marry legally. Now, more information on a story we brought you recently about a remarkable discovery in Israel. Archaeologists believe they have uncovered the remains of a palace of King David. John Waggy has that story.
About 20 miles outside of Jerusalem, archaeologists found the best example yet of a fortified city in Judah from the time of King David. Identified with biblical Sha'arayim, the city overlooked the Valley of Elah, where David killed Goliath.
Before we excavated here, there was many debate about King David, if he's a historical figure or not, and if he indeed has a kingdom and fortified cities.
Hebrew University archaeologist Professor Yossi Garfinkel says even though David is famous in the Bible, no evidence from his time as king had been found in Hebron or Jerusalem.
So people start asking, well, maybe it's all mythology, maybe it's only stories. Maybe he never existed. Or if he existed, he was just a Bedouin sheikh living in a tent, but no real kingdom, no real fortified cities.
That changed 7 years ago when the excavations here began.
And after one and two and three seasons, it turned out that we have a big city here which was heavily fortified. Some of the stone here are up to 8 tons. This is not a small village. This is a real important stronghold.
Not everyone shares this excitement. Some archaeologists caution that the site may have belonged to other kingdoms. Many believe there is no actual proof that King David existed. But Garfinkel is convinced. They found a 1,000 square meter palace at the center of the site. It had an excellent view from the Mediterranean Sea to the Hebron Mountains and Jerusalem. Another building would have been used to store taxes.
How do you collect taxes in antiquity? People they don't have salaries, so you don't have income tax like today. But people were agriculturalists, so everybody had to donate some of their product. Wheat, barley, legumes, and so on and so forth. And these were stored in big storage room, in storage jars, and in a central building.
There were no pig bones found at the site, showing that people followed the biblical commandment against eating pork. Garfinkel says all the discoveries add up.
And it's different from the Philistine, from the Canaanite, or from the Kingdom of Israel. So our conclusion is that this city is from the time of King David.
The dig at Kirbet Keafa will soon be finished as archaeologists look for more answers at another excavation site.
This area is going to be developed into a national park. To develop the place, to be a tourist area, and people from Israel and abroad, tourists can come and see the landscape, can see the only place in the world where you can see a city from the time of King David.
John Waggy, CBN News.
A gay British couple is suing the Church of England so that they can get married in an Anglican church. The United Kingdom's new same-sex marriage law forbids the Church of England from performing same-sex weddings, and it says other churches are not required to perform them. But the couple says they want to get married in their church, the Church of England. And the only way they can make that happen, they say, is by filing a lawsuit and forcing England's hand in court. The family of an American detained in North Korea for the past 9 months is renewing calls for his release. There are concerns now about his health. Kenneth Bay is an American tour operator and Christian missionary. He was arrested last November and accused of hostile acts against the North Korean government. He's been sentenced to 15 years of hard labor. His sister says his recent letters home have portrayed troubling health conditions. The family plans a prayer vigil at a Seattle church Saturday. They hope to raise awareness of the case and place more pressure on U.S. authorities to win his release. You can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.